If you're ready for your next performer, say yeah. Yeah. Let's hear it for Adrian Whitcomb.
I know some of you out there are wondering what it will be like when you go back to your 50th high school reunion. Well, I don't have long to wait. Believe it or not, I don't have long to wait. It's this weekend. Oh, y'all thought I was 39, probably. It's just the hair, I think. But I wrote this for my class reunion. Actually, I wrote it several years, a number of years ago for an earlier class reunion, but it says something about what it was like back in 1967. And you think times are rough now. For a lot of us, it was a lot rougher than 67. So this is a song. The year was 1967. The year was... The year was 1967. Our world was changing fast, it seems. As we looked to graduation, we were headed toward our dreams. We were anxious and uncertain for what the future held in store. Knew that I will soon be seeking another world outside your door. It isn't easy being 18. The world has so much to demand. Some do jobs, some went to college, others went to Vietnam. Our lives would never be the same when that day in June at last arrived. For a moment, time stood still there, and then it flew so quickly by. We had written in the beacon all the things to leave behind. An old gym suit, had finished textbooks. I wished that years from then we'd find those typhoon banners proudly waving, our alma mater loudly sung. Those memories we share together, our celebration just begun. It isn't easy to be 18 back in the 60s or today. The year was 1967. We and our friends were on our way. Some of you, perhaps, have watched the first episode of Ken Burns' Vietnam, and that goes on for a number of weeks now. And I wasn't able to watch it. I was somewhere else last night. But I clearly remember. I wasn't there. No, I wasn't there. I was in college. I was one of the lucky ones that went to college. I was 1A after college, but by then, they didn't get to my draft number, so I didn't volunteer to go there, and by then the war was pretty unpopular with a good deal of the country, and then we continued several years after that until we finally got out. But there were, of course, people in my class that had to go. They were drafted right away, or maybe some volunteered. And I don't know any that died in Vietnam, but there were certainly some that whose lives were changed by the experience. And I was just strange how all this has come out, the series, and then over at Newport News, this past weekend, they had the moving Vietnam Wall, which is a half-scale model of the Memorial Wall in Washington, D.C. And it has over 58,000 names of people that died in Vietnam. Now, these are Americans who died in Vietnam. Of course, there were many more Vietnamese that died there on both sides. In all four war, they really never really made sense. And you know, 50 years later, we've gone through other wars, and there's been questions about them too. And we never seem to learn, do we? But, well, I hope to have a good time at my reunion this weekend, and I hope all of you are still around for your 50th. Maybe one or two of you have already been to the 50th, but for the most part, you have a few years to look forward to it. So think about your experience and have a good time. Thank you.
One more time for Adrian Whitcomb, everybody. Up next on the mic, let's show our